For me, I don't think it's just about the seven of us, but it's the total shutdown of civil society operating space. So if people keep quiet, if people forget about us, one day we'll wake up with civil society, all civil society organizations banned from operating. So we need to continue speaking about our experiences, condemning the state for the arbitrary arrest and torture of human rights defenders in Zimbabwe.
I think they want to use us as guinea pigs so that whoever wants to participate in any human rights activity won't be able to do anything, because they would have set an example through the seven of us. Because right now people are so scared. So scared, even when they feel like traveling out of Zimbabwe, they are not so sure whether when they come back they are safe. And it restricts and the shrinking of the space that we are talking about is through those these kinds of actions, because nobody wants to go through what we went through. We will continue with our work, because apart from that, we are who we are, and we've got work that we are doing that can transform so many lives in Zimbabwe. She has spoken of women in politics, and speaking of women in prisons, speaking of the communities that he works with. They really need our services. And we won't stop because somebody has said that we are terrorists. We are not terrorists. So we will continue working and advocate for the rights of people in Zimbabwe. With all the labels and with all the stigma, the discrimination, the distortion of information, that won't take away what we are. Just like Star is saying, I've lived in Zimbabwe, I'm very patriotic. We are all very patriotic. We want to live in Zimbabwe.